So today is April 26, 2015. The time is now 8:33 in the morning. See that? 8:33 in the morning, April 26, 2015. I'm listening to Britney Spears singing some song, the Every Time by Britney Spears. I have all the full lyrics. I'm not gonna sing it now, but she's 33 years old. I'm 32 years old. She was born December 2nd, 1981. And she looks way different from when I knew her in high school. Yeah. She has two children and she is 32 years old. 33 years old. I'm 32. I'm gonna read this. Britney Spears, born December 2nd, 1981, is an American singer and actress. Born in Macomb, Mississippi, and raised in Kentwood, Louisiana, she performed acting roles in stage productions and television shows as a child before singing with Jive Records in 1997. Spears' first and second studio albums, Baby One More Time, Oops, I Did It Again, became international successes, with the former becoming the best-selling album by a teenage solo artist. In 2001, Spears released her self-titled third studio album, Britney, and played the starring role in the film Crossroads. She assumed creative control of her fourth studio album, In the Zone, which yielded the worldwide success of the Toxic single. In 2007, Spears' much-publicized personal issues set her career into hiatus. Her fifth studio album, Blackout, was released later that year and spawned hits such as Give Me More and Piece of Me. Her erratic behavior and hospitalizations continued through the following year, at which point she was placed under a still ongoing conservatorship. In 2013, Spears began a two-year residency show, Britney, Piece of Me, at the Excess at Planet Hollywood Resort and Casino in Las Vegas. Spears was established as a pop icon and credited with influencing the revival of teen pop during the late 1990s. She became the best-selling teenage artist of all time and garnered honorific titles including the Princess of Pop. Her work has earned her numerous awards and accolades, including Grammy Award, 6 MTV Video Music Awards, including the Lifetime Achievement Award, 9 Billboard Music Awards, and a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. She has sold over 100 million albums worldwide and over 100 million singles, making her one of the best-selling music artists of all time. Forbes reported that Britney Spears was the highest-paid female musician in 2012, with earnings of $58 million, having last topped the list in 2002. Again, this is Britney Spears. She's 33 years old. I'm 32 years old. And she has two kids. I think she's divorced twice. Life and career, 1981 to 1987. Early life and career beginnings. Oh, that song is over. Yeah. Our love is strong. Why carry on? That's Spotify right here. Spotify. Spears was born in Macomb, Mississippi, the second child of Lenny Irene Bridges and James Parnell Spears. Her maternal grandmother, Lillian Portell, was English, born in London, and one of Spears's maternal great-great-grandfathers was Maltese. Her siblings are Brian, James, and Jamie Lynn. At age of 3, she started attending dance lessons in her hometown of Kentwood, Louisiana, and was selected to perform as a solo artist at the annual recital. During her childhood, she also attended gymnastics and voice lessons and won many state-level competitions and children's talent shows. Spears made her local stage debut at age 5, saying, "What child is this?" at her kindergarten graduation. She said about her ambition as a child, "I was in my own world. I found out what I'm supposed to do at an early age." At age 8, Spears and her mother, Lynn, traveled to Atlanta, Georgia for an audition in the 1990s revival of the Mickey Mouse Club. Casting director Matt Casella rejected her for being too young to join the series at the time, but introduced her to Nancy Carson, a New York City talent agent. Carson was impressed with Spears' vocals and suggested enrolling her at the Professional Performing Arts School. Shortly after, Lynn and her daughters moved to a sublet apartment in New York. Spears was hired for her professional role as the understudy for the lead role of Tina Denmark in the off-Broadway musical Ruthless. She also appeared as a contestant on the popular television show Star Search and was cast in a number of commercials. In December 1992, she was finally cast in the Mickey Mouse Club, but returned to Kentwood after the show was canceled. She enrolled at Park Lane Academy in McComb, Mississippi. Although she made friends with most of her classmates, she compared the school to the opening scene in Clueless with all the cliques. Was so bored. "I was the point guard on the basketball team. I had my boyfriend and I went to homecoming and Christmas formal, but I wanted more." In June 1997, Spears was in talks with manager Lou Pearlman to join the female pop group Innocence. Lynn asked family friend and entertainment lawyer Larry Rudolph for his opinion, submitted a tape of Spears singing over Whitney Houston karaoke song along with some pictures. Rudolph decided he wanted to pitch her to record labels, therefore she needed a professional demo. He sent Spears an unused song of Tony Braxton. She rehearsed for a week and recorded her vocals in a studio with a sound engineer. And that was finished. Okay. Spears traveled to New York with the demo and met with executives from four labels, returning to Kentwood the same day. Three of the labels rejected her, arguing that audiences wanted pop bands such as the Backstreet Boys and the Spice Girls, and there wasn't going to be another Madonna, another Debbie Gibson, or another Tiffany. 2 weeks later, executives from Jive Records returned calls to Rudolph. Senior Vice President of A&R Jeff Finster stated that Spears' audition, that it's very rare to hear someone that age who can deliver emotional content and commercial appeal. For any artist, the motivation, the eye of the tiger, extremely important. And Britney had that. She sang Houston's I Have Nothing 1992 for the executives and got signed to the label. They appointed her to work with producer Eric Foster White for a month, who reportedly shaped her voice from lower and less poppy delivery to distinctively, unmistakably Britney. After hearing the recorded material, President Clive Calder ordered a full album. Spears had originally envisioned Sheryl Crow music, but younger, more adult contemporary felt all right with her label's appointment of producers, since it made more sense to go pop because I can dance to it, it's more me. She flew to Sharon Studios in Stockholm, Sweden, where half of the albums was recorded from March to April 1990 with producers Max Martin, Dennis Pop, and Remy Yacoum, among others. Whoa. Spears performing at the NFL kickoff live September 2003. Marriages and motherhood. Okay. Personal struggles of blackout. Whoa, freak show. Spears performing freak show at the circus starring Britney Spears, May 2009. X Factor. Spears performing Give Me More at the Femme Fatale tour, July 2011. Vocals. Oh man, there's so many pages, I have to keep scrolling down. Whoa. Spears performing on March 5th, 2009. All right, philanthropy. The singer founded the Britney Spears Foundation, a charitable entity set up to help children in need. The philosophy behind the foundation was that music and entertainment was a healing quality that can benefit children. Okay, today is April 26, 2015. The time is now 8:43 a.m. I'm gonna stop playing. Thanks for watching.